am exhausted right now. Number two, I haven't brushed my teeth yet. I should probably go do that right now.
Okay, so now that I'm a bit more awake, good morning! Once again, please excuse the quarantine hair. If you're wondering why I'm representing my Canadian pride here, even though I'm not Canadian, there's actually a story behind this sweatshirt. I bought it as a result of surviving a harsh Canadian rainstorm, and you can watch that funny ass vlog right over here in the info cards. So now let's get into this video. So let me set the stage for you, because all the footage that I filmed last night will make zero sense when not put in context. Okay, so you see, last night, my husband was bavilaing up a storm. And if you don't understand that reference, you're way too young to be watching this video, and I'm old enough to be your mom. But you know who's way older? My mom! She's turning the big six. 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 I can't count. She's turning the big 6-0 today. She's turning 60 today.
Today!
So here's the deal. A couple weeks ago, my cousin Albina messaged me with the great idea that we should do a birthday car parade for my mom due to the quarantine lockdown restrictions. This put restrictions on gatherings on more than 10 people. So I thought this was a great idea for many reasons. It's my mom's 60th. This is a huge milestone birthday. She was planning a huge surprise party for herself, which unfortunately had to be canceled. So she's been super bummed lately. That's where we come in. We are stepping in and planning it for her 60-year-old ass. Except this time, she won't know anything about it. And we'll all be wearing hazmat suits from our cars. Because if that's not a flipping good time, I don't know what is. We were also going to take a Euro trip to Scotland and England this year in celebration of her 60th trip around the sun. That's cool because it makes my mom sound like an astronaut, and how epic is that? And that was also canceled. Good thing we didn't actually make the plans yet.
Wow.
Sometimes it actually pays to procrastinate. Anyway, you get the point. So today, a car parade will be going down. She has no idea. Also, today will be the first day that this face will be wearing makeup in about 3 months. So get ready to see the very first footage of me resembling something somewhat human again. Here's the plan. We're all gonna meet at the baseball field, which is about 3 blocks from my parents' house, give or take. And then once everybody is there and situated around 7 o'clock, me and Avi are gonna head to my mom's house and we're gonna like check in, like see what's going on. I told her I was gonna come by to like drop off a gift, but once I get there, I'm gonna send a text message to my godfather, Mark, and he's actually a cop, so he's used to like these like motorcades and stuff. I'm gonna send a message to him, and then he's gonna corral everybody over to my parents' house. And then we're gonna get her ass outside, and then that's when the storm is going to hit her in the face. She is not going to see what's coming, and it's gonna be funny as hell. Well, it's gonna probably make me cry, because she's gonna start crying, and then we're all gonna start crying. And then we're gonna set out a little table by the mailbox where anybody that drives past the driveway can say a little quick hello to the birthday girl, put their little gift on the table, and then keep moving right along. So that's the plan, Stan. So yesterday I went to, not Costco, Walmart. My husband has me brainwashed. So yesterday I went to Walmart with my mask on, of course, and I bought some supplies. So last night I filled some candy bags as a thank you for all who are coming out and participating. We have about 12 to 15 cars coming through, so I'm super excited to see her reaction. This is gonna be nuts. So yeah, so here's some footage from last night of me stuffing candy bags and also making her a birthday face mask, because this is what a birthday gift looks like in the pandemic. Guys, she asked for this. I wasn't like, I'm gonna make my mom a face mask for her birthday. That's a great gift. I mean, it is a great gift, but in a normal world with no pandemic, it's not really the first thing that you would put on your birthday list. So I made her one because she asked for one, and it's kind of like mine, except way cooler. She's got pink elastic, and the front of hers I like much better. Excuse me and your butthole's in my face. Please put that away, you're offending me. So if you guys need a face mask and you missed my Olsen mask video where I show you how to make one of these really cool face masks for yourself, you can check that video out over here, or I will link it in the description down below. So anyway, without further ado, let's get into the meat and potatoes of this vlog. Here's some footage, and I'll see you back in the future a little bit after that footage. Okay, bye. Thank you. tech support.
Figures on like on the last step of the mask, and now this thing is, it keeps jamming on me.
All I have to do after this is add the hair ties, and then I'm done.
Yeah, you're supposed to try to put behind that thing.
Oops.
Just finished stuffing all the candy bags. There's a lot. Robbie's sleeping in the other room, so I'm trying to be quiet. Yeah, tonight I made her mask gift, stuffed all these candy bags, and then tomorrow I have to wrap her gifts and close it up for tonight. Then I go to bed. Tomorrow we surprise the out of her, and then, oh crap, I have to break down this table. Gonna hit the hay. I'll check in tomorrow. Good night.
So, sorry, I'm eating a Starburst, but, okay, I gotta finish this Starburst because I sound like an idiot.
Okay, so this is take two. So yesterday, I went to Walmart and I got a bunch of stuff. I'm gonna be setting up a table. So I got a really pretty iridescent table cover, kind of looks like a mermaid a little bit. When my mom comes out, she's not gonna have a freaking idea what the hell is going on. But we're gonna like Publishers Clearing House her ass. We're not gonna hand her a big check because I don't have any freaking money. We're just gonna like Miss America her and just, you know, strap this around her head. This actually lights up. That's gonna be really obnoxious and cute. You guys, how obnoxious is this? I bought her some beads. I should have bought her some obnoxious sunglasses. Maybe I'll go back to Walmart at some point today. Here's some streamers and stuff that I bought for the table or cars or whoever needs some streamers. This is for the front of the table. I might bring the table to my dad's house. I might set it up in the garage so it's like ready to go because I don't want to be like setting stuff up while people are in their cars out front waiting for things to happen. So I think having the table set up beforehand might be a good idea. I also have this cute birthday banner, which can go along the front of the table. I bought tons of balloons for anybody who wants to put some stuff on their car. And then I got this cool birthday thing. It's a balloon. It's supposed to be air-filled, not helium, because I don't think anywhere is open right now that can provide helium. I think, well, I sounded English for a second. I think all the party cities are closed right now. I think all the party cities are closed, so air-filled balloons are the best option. This came with an inflating straw. I'm not sure what that means. So here's the straw. It's literally just a straw. Oh, it's a paper straw. At least they're environmentally conscious. Where did this go? Oh my goodness. It's like a big snowflake doll. I'm not sure how this goes. I think this is heavy. Oh god. I don't see how this is gonna work. Whoa! I guess like that. I need enough lung power to get down to here. Do I have it in me? And now that I am lightheaded and probably gonna pass out, we have a beautiful birthday balloon that says happy. And that's gonna go, I don't know where it's gonna go because it's not helium, so it doesn't float. So I'm not sure what we're gonna do with this yet, but we'll have to figure it out. It's backwards. Nope, that's still backwards. There we go. Really, cat? Really? Oh, this came with string. It's a good thing that this doesn't float. We'll figure something out with this, guys. I don't know what to do with this yet. I don't know, maybe I'll wrap some gifts. I'm gonna wrap the gifts now. So let's go into the storage room and get some wrapping paper.
Oh my god! You're messy.
So for everybody who always tells me that my house is so clean, this room is like that Monica Geller room in Friends, you know, where she like puts all her shit she doesn't need. That's this room.
No, you weren't supposed to see this!
And now the cat's gone. The cat's missing. I don't know where she is. She's somewhere in here. I don't know. We'll find her later. I need some wrapping paper. So I have this leftover, which I don't know if a gift will fit into. And then I have some wrapping paper in this thingamabobber. Here's one with some candles on it. That's cute. Okay, so I found some really cute packaging to put her little face mask in. Found some cute tissue paper. Getting late and I have some errands I gotta run. We'll have to get back to this gift wrapping thing later. Okay, so I have a couple more things I gotta do before we head over to the baseball field to meet up with everybody. I printed out some thank you tags for the goodie bags. I have to put the tags on the bags. I have to put together my mom's gift for my mask. I have to also throw some oils in the bag. So I call my dad about this whole table situation because we want the table set up and ready to go. So when she comes outside, literally all we have to do is just like bring the table forward. I don't want to have to mess with any taping signs onto the table when the parade is like already happening. Okay, my original plan was that I wanted to have the table all ready to go. I was gonna go over to his house and I was gonna set up the table then because she doesn't get home till like 4:35 o'clock and I would be over there by like 3:45. So I would have to like literally like zip the table together and like bounce before she comes home from work. He said apparently like lately she's been coming home and coming through the garage because she comes home. My mom works in a nursing home, so she's on the front lines. So it is with very good reason that she comes home through the garage, strips off her clothes, and jumps right in the shower. So that causes a little bit of a dilemma because I was planning to put the table in the garage, but since she comes into the garage, can't put it there. My dad suggested putting it in the attic, but that's like three floors up, and I ain't dragging a table already decorated with like pieces that could like fall off down three flights of stairs, because that's just not gonna happen. Then another idea was to put it in the backyard, but like literally my mom is always outside, so that's not gonna work. Can't put it outside because she's gonna be home for a good like 3 hours before I even get there, and we're heading over there around 6:50, 7 o'clock. She's gonna be home way too long to give her way too much downtime to do anything before we're able to get there. So my dad was like, hey, do you know anybody with a flatbed or like a pickup truck? And I was like, actually I do. Avi's sister has a boyfriend who has a pickup truck, who has helped us many times with this pickup truck, but he's at work and I don't know their availability. But I called her and I asked her and she said she won't be able to let me know until like later. And I'm like, how later are we talking? Because I kind of need to know like now, like if this is gonna happen. Otherwise I have to figure out another plan. So that's where I'm at now. Don't know what's gonna happen with this table situation. Gotta have it decorated and ready to go. So when she comes out the door, literally all we have to do is bring it forward and it's already ready for the gifts and stuff. Yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna have to think about this. 3-ish hours to mull over this. I have some chicken nuggets and cherries. Whenever I'm planning a party or like, you know, running around like a chicken with my head cut off, my diet is that of a 5-year-old. And you know what? Probably gonna eat chicken nuggets for dinner later too. I'm on a time crunch. I got a lot of stuff to do. I'll see you later, guys. All right, guys, it is go time. Now I'm on a time crunch. The clock starts now. Gotta head to the farmer's market, get a bouquet of flowers, then I gotta go to Walmart, and I gotta get another couple bags of candy, some more goodie bags. Gotta stick the stickers on the goodie bags. I cut all those out before, and I'm gonna get her a pair of like silly glasses. Oh, I figured out the table situation. Reina, her boyfriend's truck is like broken or something. The flatbed is broken, so his dad doesn't want him to put stuff on it, so that's a no-go. We can't use that. But then I posted in the surprise Facebook group. I asked if anybody had a pickup truck. Nobody responded, but my neighbor, good old Shannon, she responded and was like, hey, I could help bring the table over. And I was like, perfect. So what I'm proposing to do, and she lives like, she doesn't live on my street directly. She lives like the next corner over, and the route has to pass by her house before they turn onto my parents' street. So I'm gonna tell my godfather Mark, who is in charge of the whole parade, to just stop at her house, give a little beep beep signal, and then once the procession starts, she can start walking the table over. Once I'm done running my errands, I'm gonna go to her house. She's gonna start helping me piece the table decor together. Then I'm gonna go run home, finish goodie bags, gather the gifts, throw myself together, and then get ready to go over to the baseball field because people are gonna start showing up between 6:15 and 6:45-ish. Yeah, I talked to my mom briefly via text today. She's really busy at work, but she gets home around 5. So she just thinks that I'm just coming to drop something off, which I am. I'm like, you know, I'm gonna just drop off some flowers, like, nonchalantly or whatever. And then, oh, beep, beep, who's out front? So that's gonna be fun. I can't wait. So, yeah, errands. Let's go. All right, we are at the store. Do this! Out. That was fairly quick. Now we're gonna go to Walmart. We're at Walmart. Round 2. Here we go. Okay, I think we're good. I think that's the fastest that I've ever shopped in Walmart. All right, so now there's a little bit of a toss-up. So the table that I was gonna use is at my house. My dad's house is on the way back from here. I should have gone to my house first, but my mom is the hoarder of folding tables. So I'm gonna go to my dad's first and see if I can find the one that she has. Take off all the stuff she has on it. She might get a little suspicious if she sees it missing, especially if she has papers and stuff on it, which she most likely will, because not only is she the hoarder of folding tables, she's also the hoarder of papers. Okay, so I made an executive decision. I think I'm just gonna go home and use my table because it's already 4:15 and we're heading into dangerous territory. She says she gets home around 5, but sometimes people get home early. So I'm not gonna chance it. I'm not gonna chance her seeing me possibly. And also I don't want her to notice that her table has mysteriously gone missing. I'm just gonna go home. As much of an inconvenience as it is, I'm gonna take off all the stuff off my table and then I'll bring that over to Shannon's house to decorate. Probably after I get some more stuff that I need to get done at home. So home I go right now. Murphy's Law. There's a freaking train now. I am waiting at a train. Look at this traffic. This is ridiculous. Why won't you move? Anything that could go wrong will go wrong. Oh, Jesus. Okay guys, so I'm back in the studio, got my little tags, and I'm going to put them on all my bags. It is like 6:15 now. I took a quick shower, did my hair, did some quick makeup, minus the foundation, because I don't even know where that is. I haven't seen it in 3 months. Yeah, we are running a little late, heading to the baseball field now. My contact, who was in charge of the table stuff, is not answering her phone, so I'm a little freaking out right now. There's one person at the baseball field so far, and we're gonna head there now. Wish us luck. I have butterflies, major butterflies. I'm so nervous.
What'd you feel?
That one.
my original contact never did come through with the help I needed with the table. But that's okay, because last minute, someone answered my request in the party group. We had our pickup.
So, we found somebody with a flatbed. These are all the cars.
Okay, so I'm just passing out some streamers and balloons, and then me and Avi are gonna head over, and then once I give Mark the signal, parade time.
Happy birthday!
Oh, thank you! 16 hours!
How many hours?
I'm on filming duty.
I don't have my... Okay then. Where did your brother go?
That's for you.
Thank you!
Happy birthday!
From all of us.
Oh, I have two more gifts in the car.
How many more gifts?
Yes.
They're on the way right now. You're the worst.
Because people are texting me on my phone. I don't want her to see the phone blowing up.
Yeah, but they're on their way.
So what? I'm saying I'm going to get the gifts. Helping you get the gifts.
They're about to pull around the corner.
Okay, good. You have the camera. It's rolling, right? Is it rolling?
Yeah, but she's not out here.
So what? She's going to hear the beeper. She's going to come.
All right, close that.
Where are they?
Here they come. Where is she?
Oh, my God.
birthday.
Thank you, Ollie.
The driveway on your birthday.
No, that was
how
earlier.
How did you feel?
No, I was pissed when I came in and I said, what's for dinner? He said, I'm making a quick sauce. I said, on my birthday? Okay, I'll remember that. And then I came, he goes, I'm making cavatelle and broccoli. And I came down to a candle lit and wine and the cavatelle and broccoli, which I love. And it was much nicer.
Guys. So we got here and then you were a little suspicious. You said, no, what's going on? You said, you guys are acting weird.
Yeah, but I didn't think like this. I thought that maybe like Vin decided, okay, I'm gonna fly and take a
during a pandemic.
Well, some people are still flying.
I know.
So I mean, I don't know. I was just like, what are you up to? You were acting weird. I was like, do you want to sit outside? No, it's too cold. Jeopardy.
I have to admit, I was acting weird, but like I had my mask on and like I couldn't wear it to Avi. I was like, oh, text them to come now.
He's like, yeah, I'm filming. We
and then I said, do you want me to get my mask on? And she said, I guess so.
This is what I heard.
I have my mask on!
She was looking at me with the mask on and I see the eyes.
Yeah, the eyes! That's all I saw! So I was like, I guess it's happening.
What does that mean? Thank you very much. This is, I'll never forget this. This was wonderful.
So happy 60th, Mamacita.
Thank you. I'm gonna sleep well tonight. Thank you, everybody. To my family and friends. I'm exhausted now.
I think you're exhausted now. Just watch the vlog and all the lead up to this. All right, guys, so that's it. That's the end of the vlog. And I will leave you with the short clip from my brother Vin on the cell phone to see you guys out. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. I will see you soon.
Bye.
Peace
out. If you like this video, make sure you click the thumbs up, like, subscribe, and watch all of our future videos that are coming up in the future. Thanks, guys. You rock.
I can see the fan moving.
Thank you so much to my patrons, Megan Baker, Dee Carubia, and Michelle Zeman for making this video possible. If you would like to help support these videos, you can join me on my creative journey at patreon.com/bohemianmagicstudios.
Lullaby. Somewhere.
skies are blue and the dreams that you dare.